Have you ever dreamt of cruising at 60,000 feet, watching the Earth's curve against the black sky, while cities blur past under you at Mach 2? Welcome to the supersonic era, where two aircraft, the Concorde and the Tu-144, stood as the crown jewels of this audacious dream. Beyond the sonic booms and sleek silhouettes lies a battle of engineering ideologies, Cold War politics, and design philosophies. This isn't just about which one flew faster. It's about why one etched its name in history, while the other became a cautionary tale. Let's dive into the differences between these two supersonic icons. Technical race begins. The race to develop a commercial supersonic transport wasn't just about bragging rights, it was a cutting-edge contest of material science, aerodynamics, and propulsion. Concorde, a joint venture between British Aircraft Corporation and Aerospatiale, embraced aerodynamic purity. The Soviets, with Tupolev OKB, aimed to outpace them with brute force engineering. Fun fact, the Tu-144 beat Concorde to the sky by just 2 months, making it the first SST to fly. But speed doesn't always mean success. Aerodynamics form vs function. The Concorde's iconic OG Delta wing was the result of meticulous wind tunnel testing. Its shape created leading-edge vortices at high angles of attack, generating lift during takeoff and landing without compromising cruise efficiency. In contrast, the Tu-144 used a cranked delta wing with retractable canards. The canards added extra lift and pitch control, but also introduced complexity and drag. Think of it as the difference between sculpting marble versus bolting on spare parts. One is seamless, the other functional but clunky. The Concorde was powered by four Rolls-Royce/Snecma Olympus 593 turbojet engines with afterburners. These engines, optimized for high-altitude supersonic cruise, featured variable intake ramps, sophisticated control logic, and reheat afterburner for takeoff and transonic acceleration. The Tu-144 initially used Kuznetsov NK-144 engines, which were less efficient and noisier. They lacked variable geometry intakes and suffered from high fuel burn. The upgraded Tu-144D switched to Kolesov RD-3651 turbojets, closer in performance to the Olympus but still lagging in efficiency. Fun fact. At full afterburner, Concorde could burn a ton of fuel in just 6 minutes. Structural design and materials. Both aircraft used high-strength aluminium alloys, but Concorde's structure underwent extreme thermal testing. At Mach 2, the aircraft's skin heated up to over 120 degrees Celsius. Designers had to factor in thermal expansion of over 20 centimeters in length. The Tu-144 faced similar issues but with a heavier airframe and less refined materials, struggling with stress fractures and fatigue. Flight envelopes and handling. Concorde's flight control surfaces were fully hydraulically actuated with artificial feel. Its center of gravity was actively managed by pumping fuel fore and aft to maintain trim. The Tu-144, though equipped with canards, had a more twitchy flight envelope, requiring constant pilot correction, especially during approach and landing. Fun fact, Concorde landed at around 160 knots, faster than most airliners at cruising speed. Cockpit and avionics. Concorde's flight deck was advanced for its time with early analog-digital hybrid systems and sophisticated environmental control for pressurization. Tu-144 cockpits retained more traditional Soviet instrumentation with less automation. On paper, the Tu-144 was faster and carried more passengers. In practice, Concorde was vastly more reliable, efficient, and comfortable. Safety and fatal flaws. The 1973 crash at the Paris Air Show dealt a crippling blow to the Tu-144. The aircraft disintegrated mid-air during a high-speed maneuver, killing 6 crew and 8 civilians. Concorde, despite a tragic crash in 2000, had a pristine safety record until then. The cause was foreign object damage, not design failure. Fun fact, Concorde's tires were nitrogen-filled and built to withstand over 500 kilometers per h during takeoff. Legacy and lessons. The Tu-144 was a technical overreach demonstrating Soviet capability, but not sustainability. Concorde represented the pinnacle of Western aerospace cooperation. Both aircraft were commercial failures but influenced high-speed flight research, material science, and propulsion. Today, companies like Boom Supersonic and NASA are resurrecting the dream. The Concorde and Tu-144 paved the way with lessons written in titanium and blood. Outro. Two aircraft, one dream, different paths. Concorde was elegance through engineering. Tu-144 was a sprint to supremacy. Which one do you think deserves the crown? Let me know in the comments. Until next time, keep your eyes on the Mach meter.